In this lesson, we are going to learn about reading chemical formulas of ions. Now, what are chemical formulas? Chemical formulas are basically a way for scientists to use letters and numbers to represent a substance. For instance, water is H2O. See how the letter H represents hydrogen and the letter O represents oxygen. And the number 2 is a number that represents there are 2 atoms of hydrogen. And when there's no number, we assume it's going to be 1, so therefore 1 atom of oxygen in H2O. Now in the chemical formula of ions, there are 2 common numbers that you need to understand. The first one is called a superscript. A superscript, think of the word Superman, right? Superman always flying high. You can think of this number as the number that's flying above the element symbol. Here I have a generic element symbol, X, and here I have the subscript flying above up there. Now that number up there, or superscript, indicates the charge of an ion. And we talk about that later. So what does it mean, a charge of an ion? Remember, ions are basically an atom that has gained or lost electrons to be stable. So in this case, I can give you a quick example. Here we have barium, right? When barium loses 2 electrons, it becomes barium 2+. So we have the superscript right there. That represents the charge of barium. Or we can say the other way around, where oxygen has gained 2 electrons to be stable, and oxygen is going to have 2-. Notice how the 2 are not written right here, but it's written on top or above the chemical symbols. That's why we call it a superscript. Another number that we have to be familiar with is called a subscript. Now, think of the subway. The subway go under the ground, right? In this case, it go under the element symbol. And this number indicates the number of atoms of a specific element. What does that mean? If I have O2, remember O2 right there? Right, this is oxygen gas, it's not an ion. But that 2 right there, that tells you that there are 2 of oxygen atoms in oxygen gas. Or we can go back to H2O, see that 2 right there? That tells you there are 2 of the hydrogen atoms. So it tells you the number of atoms of a specific element. This 2 does not apply to oxygen, it's only applied to the element symbol that's going in front of the number. The subscript is applied to the element that's in front of it, not behind it, okay? So the 2 is going toward the H, not the O. This is wrong. Sometimes, when we have polyatomic ions, we have to group them in parentheses, because polyatomic ions is a group of atoms that combine together, but they function as a unit. And we're going to show you some example. Let's look at this one right here. What are the superscripts? This would be the charges on here. Okay? So that is your charges right there. And this subscript right there tell you that this polyatomic ions has 1 sulfur, because there's no subscript there, but it has 4 oxygen atoms. Okay? So that's what it means. 4 oxygen and 2-. And then if we look over here, we look at ammonium right here, NH4+, that 4 tell you there are 4 of the hydrogen. But the overall charge of this whole entire polyatomic ions is just 1+. And in this case, we have oxygen ions. It's called oxide, remember? We drop the ending, so oxygen is like this. And we drop the ending, and we add IDE. So if you remember how to name negative ions, please watch the video below right here. Click on the link. So the name for this would be oxide, okay? So in this case, there's no subscript. We know it's gonna be just 1. But the charge overall is 2-. Then we have calcium. A lot of students get tricked by Ca. Notice how this is capitalized and this is lowercase. When that happened, you have to realize this is just 1 element. Okay? If you have Ca, then this is 1 element, this is another element. But in this case, the A is a lowercase. That means it is a single element. Just like we have Ba, aluminum, Al. So So you have to realize those are one single element. In this case, calcium has a charge of 2+. So how are we going to apply this to our homework when you type the answer online? So first of all, we're just going to type normally because we cannot use subscript and superscript. But we can do something to separate the charges from the rest of the formula. See how there's a charge right there, right? And here's the rest of the formula. So we're just going to type in SO4, then we're going to use the caret symbol to represent that the charge is flying above the rest of the formula with a 2-. So that's how you type in your answer. Okay, and for this one, you would have NH4, okay, and the caret symbol, plus. And over here, we have O, just O, right, and caret symbol, 2-. And then for oxygen, let me circle the answer for you, or box the answer for you. Then we have calcium, of course, going to be Ca, and then use a caret to separate the charges from the formula, the 2+. That's how you type your answer on our website.